वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस प्रैक्टिकल दैट इज टू डिटरमाइन क्रिटिकल माइसेलर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ गिवन सर्फैक्टेंट। रिक्वायरमेंट्स टू कंडक्ट दिस प्रैक्टिकल, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल सी अपैरेटस, स्टलैग्मोमीटर, बीकर्स, मेजरिंग सिलेंडर, रबर कॉर्क, ब्यूरेट स्टैंड एंड कॉटन। देन केमिकल्स रिक्वायर्ड टू परफॉर्म दिस प्रैक्टिकल, वाटर फॉर वॉशिंग पर्पज, देन क्रोमिक एसिड एंड नाइट्रिक एसिड for cleaning your stalagmometer before use, then distilled water for preparation of different dilution of surfactant, and last is surfactant. Before moving ahead towards this critical micellar concentration, we'll discuss what exactly surfactants. Then we'll move towards the critical micellar concentration of the particular surfactant. Surfactants are interfacially active compounds. They are having the ability to act at an interface or surface of your substance. They are acting at an interface of two immiscible liquids. Then they consist of polar head group and non-polar hydrocarbon chain, and polar part of molecule can interact strongly with polar solvent like water, and therefore it is called hydrophilic part. Then the non-polar part on the other hand can form a strong interaction with non-polar solvent like oils, and therefore also called lipophilic. So surfactants are amphiphile in nature, means they are having the ability to solubilize into lipophilic as well as hydrophilic solvents because of the specialized type of groups are present on this monomer of surfactants. So depending upon which charge is present on the head of your surfactant monomer, they are classified into four subclasses. First class, that is anionic surfactant. In these type of the surfactant, head portion carries a negative charge, and that's why it is known as anionic surfactants. Then second type of surfactants are cationic surfactant. In these type of the surfactant, head part of monomer of surfactant carries positive charge. And third type of surfactant is zwitterionic surfactant. In these type of the surfactant, head part carries both the charges, that is positive charge and negative charge. So two charges exist together, that's why it is known as the zwitterionic surfactants. Then fourth part of surfactant, fourth type of surfactant, that is non-ionic surfactant. In these type of surfactant, there is no charge species on the head part. That's why it is known as the non-ionic surfactants. This is a structure of monomer unit of surfactant. This is head. It carries hydrophilic group, and this is your hydrophobic tail. So this portion, hydrophilic portion, carries a charge, and depending on this we'll get these four classes: anionic, cationic, deuterion and non-ionic. So here charge species are there. If it is positive, then it is cationic surfactant. If it is negative, then it is anionic surfactant. If both the charges are there on this head part, then it is deuterionic surfactant. And if no charge is there on this head part, then it is non-ionic surfactants. Now we'll see what exactly the micellization. How this micelle is formed. Now this micelle is an aggregate of surfactant molecules dispersed in a liquid colloids, and the process of formation of micelle is known as micellization. This micelle formation in a polar and non-polar solvent depend on the concentration of surfactant in particular solvent. At a specific concentration, your surfactant start to produce micelle. If add a surfactant in a solvent at a low concentration, some monomer dispersed in a solvent or aggregate at the interface or a surface until all surface or interface saturated by surfactants. Further addition of surfactant increase concentration of monomers, and it goes in solvent and start to form a micelle. When a surface part get occupied by this monomer, then this monomer entered into the bulk of solution and they start to form a micelle, and this process is known as micellization. And this concentration is called as critical micellar concentration. The concentration of surfactant at which micellization is started, that concentration is known as critical micellar concentration. So if you observe this diagram, when you have a less concentration of your surfactant in your solution, then this monomer arranged themselves on the surface. When you add further molecules of your surfactants, then again few monomers align with the surface. If you have a concentration at or above the critical micellar concentration, this monomer forms a micelle, and the concentration is known as critical micellar concentration. So the concentration of monomer at which the micelle are start to form in a solvent at a particular temperature, micelle form only when a concentration of surfactant greater than CMC. Here I take example of two different immiscible phases, that is oil and water. Then if you want to make them miscible, you have to add the surfactant. Then what happens? Initially your surfactants start to occupy this interface, okay, and when it reaches up to the CMC, it start to form a micelle. So what happened? This oil globule surrounded by the surfactant, and there is a formation of O by W type of emulsion. When you add a sufficient amount of your surfactant, your oil globules equally distributed into this aqueous phase, and there is a formation of O by W type of emulsion. Then we'll see how exactly this micelle get formed. Now, if you have an aqueous solution with you and you have added surfactant in this aqueous solution, so structure of micelle will be like this. Okay, you have a bulk solution aqueous in nature, then this head part is lies outward and hydrophobic portion, which is a tail part, and the tail part is lies inward if you have a aqueous solution with you. Then if you have a fatty solution or oily solution with you, then this tail part, which is having a hydrophobic group, it lies outward and head part is lies inward. Okay, this head part is lying inward because this hydrophobic part is having a good interaction with oil, because oil is also hydrophobic and this tail part is also hydrophobic. That's why arrangement is like this. And when you have an aqueous solution with you, this hydrophilic head is having a very good interaction with hydrophilic or aqueous solution. That's why structure of your micelle will be like this. Now we'll see Ostwald stalagmometer. By using the stalagmometer, we'll determine surface tension of given solution and we can calculate critical micellar concentration. Now this Ostwald stalagmometer is a device for the investigation of surface tension by using this stalagmometric method. It is also called stactometer, and this device is a capillary glass tube whose middle section is widened. So if you observe this diagram, this middle portion is widened, which is having a structure like bulb. So this glass bulb is there at a middle portion. Whole stalagmometer is made up of glass. Then volume of drop can be predetermined by designing of stalagmometer. Then the lower end of tube is narrowed to force the fluid to flow out of this tube as a drop. This lower end is having a less diameter as compared to this upper end. It is narrow as compared to the upper part, and it is helpful to form a drop, and this drop will be fall down into this beaker. And when this drop form, when a drop or when a moment at which a weight of your drop is in equilibrium state with surface tension, then there is a formation of drop. Now this is all about the construction. Now we'll one more thing, that is labeling. This upper part is having a mark, that mark is known as mark A, and this lower part is having a mark B. Now we'll see a working. Now what you have to do, you have to take your test liquid, you have to fill up to these mark, and then you have to flow it up to this mark B. Now during the movement of your liquid from mark A to mark B, how much drops are formed, that number of drops you have to calculate during this movement of liquid from mark A to mark B. Now we'll see a procedure of the experiment. First step, that is cleaning step. In this step you have to clean your stalagmometer and density bottle with chromic acid or nitric acid, then mount your stalagmometer into the vertical position to avoid any unnatural fall of drop. Then you have to prepare a different strength of your surfactant, still from 0.01 to 0.1% by weight by volume of your surfactant solution. So likewise, we have to prepare 10 dilution, 0.01, 0.02 up to the 0.1% weight by volume of your surfactant into the distilled water. Then what you have to do, you have to determine density of your each liquid by using a specific gravity bottle. Now what exactly the procedure of determination of your density of liquid? You have to take a density bottle, you have to weigh it and note down the weight of that empty bottle. Then you have to fill that bottle with your sample. Then again you have to take a weight of that density bottle. Then you will come to know that how much amount of or how much weight of liquid is there when you fill this density bottle. Then you have to minus a empty bottle weight from that filled bottle weight. Then you will get mass of your liquid. Now that mass you have to divide with a capacity of that bottle into the ml. Suppose it is 10 ml, then you have to divide this weight with 10 ml. Then you will get a density of that particular liquid by using formula mass upon volume. Then you have a densities of all liquid with you. Now you have to proceed for next part, that is actual determination of surface tension. For the actual determination of surface tension, first of all, we have to consider one reference liquid, and that is your distilled water. So first of all, you have to fill your stalagmometer up to the mark A with distilled water, and then we have to calculate number of drops formed during movement of liquid or during movement of water from mark A to mark B. Then you have to take a reading for your water three times. Means for each liquid you have to determine number of drops formed during movement of liquid from mark A to mark B. So likewise, you have to fill your stalagmometer with your test liquid, and again you have to take three reading of your test liquid. Likewise, you have to take a reading of all solutions three times, then repeat about a step three times to obtain correct reading. So you have to take an average of this all three reading, and that average you have to take for the calculation. Now next part, that is graph. You have to plot a graph surface tension versus concentration of surfactant. So when you plot a graph, it will be like this: surface tension versus surfactant concentration. Then initially concentration of your surfactant is less, so this will be the condition, alignment of your monomer on surface of liquid. Slowly slowly you are increasing concentration of surfactant, so first of all these monomers occupy a surface layer, and when you add an extra amount of your surfactant, then it start to form a micelle, and this is your concentration of surfactant at which there is a formation of critical micellar concentration. And after that CMC, you will get a value of surface tension constant. There is no further decrease in a surface tension of your liquid. okay, this is all about the theoretical part. Now we'll see actual practical demonstration of this experiment.
For conducting this practical, first of all, you have to prepare a different dimensions of surfactants. Here I have prepared a different dimensions of surfactant. This is your 0.0% of surfactant. Then this is 0.01%. Likewise, I have prepared up to the 1% of different dimensions of this surfactant. Now, we will determine critical micellar concentration of this given surfactants. First of all, for this experiment, we required to determine density of your liquid. So, for that purpose, I am going to use this density bottle. It is having a capacity 10 ml. So, first of all, you have to take a weight of this empty bottle. Then you have to fill this bottle with this liquid. Then you have to place this cap and extra liquid. Wipe with the help of cotton. And then you have to take a weight of this filled bottle. Then you will come to know that what is the mass of this 10 ml liquid. So that empty bottle weight you have to take, you have to minus the empty bottle weight from this filled bottle. Then you will come to know that your 0% of surfactant is having a this much mass. So by using a formula, density is equal to mass upon volume. So you have to take whatever mass you will get after minusing the weight of your empty bottle from this filled bottle weight, and then you have to divide that mass with the 10 ml because volume of this bottle is 10. So likewise, you require to calculate density of all this liquid still from 0% to 0.1%. Then you have to take your first liquid, which is a 0%. There is no addition of your surfactants. So for determination of your surfactant critical micellar concentration, we are going to use this stalagmometer. And this stalagmometer, we are going to determine surface tension of this given surfactant. Then we'll come to know that what is critical micellar concentration. So for this experiment, this is your stalagmometer. So this stalagmometer is having a capillary like structure, and one bulb is there at the middle position, and upper part of this stalagmometer is having one mark and lower part is having one mark. So what you have to do, you have to adjust your stalagmometer in vertical position with the help of this burette stand. Then as you are ready with this stalagmometer, you have to take your first liquid, or you can take a distilled water. Then likewise, you have to adjust your rubber bulb here, and then you have to suck this liquid into this stalagmometer. So how much you can take a liquid inside this stalagmometer, you have to adjust a level of liquid up to this mark A. So, I have adjusted level of this liquid up to the mark A. Now, I will remove my finger and I will start to count the number of drops formed at the bottom of this stalagmometer. Now, I will remove this finger, and then formation of drop is there, and likewise the drops entering into this beaker. So you have to calculate how much number of drops are there during movement of your liquid from this mark A to mark B. Now we'll see how this movement of liquid is there from mark A to mark B. this liquid goes down slowly. Now level of liquid is up here into the bulb of this stalagmite. So slowly, slowly drop formation is there at the bottom of your stalagmite, and this liquid is coming down. If you observe the level of liquid, it is slowly, slowly goes down, and right now it is just reaching to the mark D. So you have to stop your experiment. Then I will remove this liquid from the stalagmometer. Then I take a distilled water. Then I will wash it. You have to fill this stalagmometer with the help of rubber ball. Wash it carefully. Now this stalagmometer is ready to use for second reading. Now I am going to take a 0.1% of surfactant solution. Now same procedure I am going to follow, that I will feed this stalagmometer up to this A mark. So you have to adjust the level of liquid slightly above the mark of this A, then you can adjust exactly up to the this level, that is mark A level. So with the help of your fingertip, you have to adjust the level of liquid in this stalagmometer. Now I have adjusted this level. Now I will remove my finger, and then drop formation is started, and that drop we have to count during this moment of liquid from this mark A to mark B. So likewise you have to conduct this experiment for 3 times for each liquid and for each dilution, 0.02, 0.03, then 0.04, 0.05, 0.06, 0.07, 0.08, 0.10, and 0.1%. So I am going to take a reading for each and every liquid for 3 times. The same procedure you have to follow 3 times for each liquid, and you have to count how much number of drops are there. And then you can calculate the surface tension of your liquid, and then you can plot a graph. Okay, now we'll see a calculation part.
Now we'll discuss calculation part. Observations: room temperature 25 degree centigrade, then density of water, that is rho 1, we are going to calculate. Then density of test liquid, that is rho 2. Then surface tension of water, that is gamma 1, 72.8 dyne per centimeters. First of all, we'll see calculation of density. For this purpose, first of all, you have to take a weight of empty specific gravity bottle. This will be your W1 value. And secondly, you have to fill that bottle with water and take a weight of that filled bottle. This weight will be your W2 gram. Then weight of your empty specific gravity bottle plus liquid, that is your test liquid, you have to fill in this bottle, and this will be your W3 value. Then you want exact weight of your bottle. For that purpose, you have to minus this W1 value from W2, then you will get exact weight of your water. Likewise, when you minus this W3 from W1 from this W3, then you will get weight of your test liquid. Then by using formula, rho is equal to m upon v. M is mass and v is volume of that bottle. So here volume is 10 ml and value of m will be your W2 minus W1. So density of water will be W2 minus W1 divided by v. So here it is 27.73. This value of W2 is 27.73. And value of W1 is 17.38. So you have to divide it with 10, then we'll get a value of density of water, that is 1.035 gram per ml. Okay, this is about water. Now same way we have to calculate density of your test liquid. Here W3 value is 27.69. Then we require to minus empty bottle weight and divide it with the volume of bottle. It is 10 ml. So density of your first test liquid is 1.031 gram per ml. So likewise, you have to calculate density of all these dilutions. Now we have calculated 0.01 and 0% and 0.01% solution density. Likewise, you have to calculate all these. Then next part is determination of surface tension. Now we have a reading with us, as we have seen how to determine this number of drops for each liquid. So for each liquid you require to take reading, take a three reading, and that three reading you have to put into the observation table. Likewise 1, 2, and 3, then you have to take average of these three. Here 47, 48, and 46, so average of these three reading is 47. Then in second observation it is 60, 62, and 64, so average is 62. So likewise you can calculate. So here average of this three reading is 62, so this is your N2 value and this is your N1 value, number of drops of your water, and that 0% is surfactant. So it is N1 value and this is your N2 value. So each N2 value you have to put into this formula of surface tension. You can calculate surface tension. Now we'll see what exactly the formula for the calculation of surface tension. So here surface tension of your test liquid gamma 2 is equal to N1, number of drops of your water, into density of your test liquid, okay, for which you want to determine a surface tension of by using this formula. Then N2, number of drops of your test liquids, and rho 1 is a density of your water, and into gamma 1 is surface tension of your water. So all this value we have with us, so just we have to put this value into the formula and calculate surface tension. So for first test liquid, for 0.01 I have calculated here, it is 55.18. Likewise, just we have to replace a value of your rho 2 and n 2 and calculate accordingly a surface tension up to the 0.1% of your dilution. Now we have a different readings with us, that is percent concentration of your surfactant, and accordingly we have calculated surface tension of this all dilutions. Now you require to plot a graph, a surface tension versus concentration of surfactant. Okay, here on x-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 0.01% weight by volume of your surfactant. So 0.01, 0.02, likewise we have to take a scale on x-axis, and on y-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 10 dynes per centimeter, 10 dynes. So this scale you have to take and plot a graph, then we'll get such a type of the graph. Now if you observe this graph, initially surface tension goes on decreasing, and after that, after a certain value, you will get almost same value of surfactant. It is almost 43, after this 0.05% of your surfactant. So this is your critical micellar concentration for given surfactants. Now we'll put this value and convert this percent weight by volume into moles per liter. So CMC is equal to 20 into C divided by 1000 into M. So here M is your molecular weight of surfactant. Then after calculating this 20 into C, C means this is the critical micellar concentration obtained from the graph, then 1000 divided by 1000 into molecular weight of your surfactant. So after calculating all this, we'll get a value 3.46 moles per liter. So we can write a result that a critical micellar concentration of given surfactant was found to be 3.46. Now we'll see questions that will be asked in synopsis. What is micelle? A micelle or micella is an aggregate of surfactant molecules dispersed in a liquid forming a colloidal suspension. A typical micelle in water form a aggregate with the hydrophilic head region in contact with surrounding solvent, sequestering the hydrophobic single tail region in the micelle center. This is diagrammatic presentation of micelle. They align themselves into the circular manner. This is hydrophilic head and this is hydrophobic tail. Now this is aqueous solution, that's why these hydrophilic heads are outwards. Then second question, what is critical micellar concentration? As a concentration of surfactants are added into the detergent mixture, the surface tension will decrease. However, at some point, the surface becomes saturated with surfactant molecules and micelle start to form. And this point is defined as critical micelle concentration. And after this point, the addition of surfactant will no longer affect surface tension and is therefore unnecessary. when you initially add amount of surfactant, likewise it start to align on the surface, and when all your surface gets saturated, after this point this monomer enter into the bulk of liquid and form a micellae, and a concentration at which it start to form a micellae, this is known as critical micellar concentration. Then third question, what are the different structural forms of micellae? These are two different forms of micellae. The first form is into the aqueous solution. If your solution is aqueous in nature, these monomer align themselves in such a way that hydrophilic heads are arranged outwards. But in fatty solution, this hydrophobic tails are outwards. So likewise, these different forms of micellae are formed into the different type of the solvents. Then fourth question, why a surface tension remain constant after CMC? So below to the CMC, surface tension decreases with increase into the surfactant concentration, and as a number of surfactant at the interface increases above the CMC, in contrast the surface tension of solution is constant because interfacial surfactant concentration does not change anymore. Then fifth question, what is effect of temperature on CMC? So for each surfactant at system temperature increases, CMC initially decreases and then increases owing to the smaller probability of hydrogen bond formation at a higher temperature. And the onset of micellization tends to occur at higher concentration as temperature increases. So this is all about critical micellar concentration. Thank you.